So there's a lot of people here already at the Brave Coast, and of course it's already very interesting. And there's even a visitor area where you can sit and watch the spectacle that is about to commence. And well, I'm really looking forward to it because, well, you know, I always think it's very interesting to see what people come up with for building everything and then not just building it but also using it, because well, you know, Bartholomew does such a good job with giving us all these parts and pieces that we all fit together and really build things that they never thought about. And anyway, Ned is still explaining the rules. Currently, he is explaining some fine points to things that people asked. And we know already that the first round will be Glinda the Goodrich versus Jacob Canaan, which is, well, I know Glinda because she comes at my bar sometimes. And I know, of course, Jacob also because the community knows each other. So if you do want to get known, then it's always useful to go to these events because then people will actually see you and they will see, oh yeah, hey, I seen that person before. Now Ned is saying where people will start, and that's somewhere that I can't see, but it's at the entrance of the maze that they built. And then people will have to travel through the maze while not jumping over the stone walls, and then find this phone, which is somewhere else, which I cannot see because it is so dark currently because it is night. And fortunately, some people use the light spell, which means that there is some light, because really, we need more lights because we don't have currently can have enough lights on our lots, I think, especially outside. It's a limit of 4 or 6 lights or something. And of course, because we currently have recently switched to Unity 5, the frame rate for a lot of people will be very different and mostly improved for most people, which is really good because it means that they can move a lot better than some people could. And that means that oh, Ned says also that you can use spells like light spell and night vision, which is you're very useful at night because really you can't see. I can't see any dog or cat anywhere, but that could also be because nobody has their pets out, which is good because that used to really cut down on frame rates somehow. And Bambino and Ned now asks Bambino and Glinda on the phone, please, because we're about to get started with the first round. Oh, Bambino? Does that mean that Bambino will be replacing Jacob Canaan? I don't know, but maybe it is, because yes, it seems like that. That instead of what I've been saying, that Glinda the Goodrich and Jacob Canaan will be doing the first round, it will be Glinda the Goodrich and Bambino Ludovate, or Fate, or whatever, who is doing the first round. And I'm probably saying it wrong. And Ned is counting down. He's saying 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, run! And they're running through the maze, and both are running exactly the same way. And they're not attacking each other, but they both have light, so I can see them traveling through the maze. And they are going for the throne, and oh, they seem to have been gotten lost in the maze, because they both just keep running after each other, and that's not always a good idea if you don't know how to travel the maze. And well, they still haven't found their way out, but that's not a problem because if they take longer than 5 minutes, then the round will be ended. And the commentary says, "Run, Luke, run!" And of course, I haven't seen any Luke because, well, Luke Skywalker is an entirely other thing, I think. I haven't seen him, at least in-game. Anyway, Bambino now has made itself out of the maze, and so has Glinda, and Bambino is jumping up the cupboards and finding the throne, and well, he is still going and going. And meanwhile, Glinda is found a completely different route, and I've completely lost them out of my view. But I have a view of the throne, and I assume that they are just trying to get there, because it's really not an easy track that they have to travel, because there's a lot of jumping involved after the maze. And of course they are also trying to kill each other, which is also very useful, because if you kill somebody, then of course you can worry about the throne on your own time, as long as you don't beat the 5-minute time. And that says that, oh, a minute has passed, 4 minutes till sudden death, and I hope that sudden death won't happen, because I don't want to die, I'm not ready for that. And he says, oh, don't worry, Woody, because there's no attacks allowed after that. And I see that Jacob Kanane has also made it, so maybe he can take another round. And anyway, the throne is apparently on an easy fight, on an easy to reach spot, which is very good, and they are currently not attacking each other anymore, but they haven't made it to the throne either. And oh dear, where are they, because I see them again. They have made it far from the cupboards, and they have almost got it, but maybe. And they keep running around and not going to the throne, which is, and instead they seem to be wanting to fight each other instead. And Glinda seems to have taken an entirely new tactic by going completely to try to jump off all the cupboards, and in the meantime, oh dear, Glinda was the victim of a gust spell and was blown down, and oh dear, now they are wanting to take revenge. And meanwhile, Bambino tries to run away from Glinda and go and find to his phone, and he seems to jump, and Ned says 2 minutes till sudden death. But I think that finally Bambino has found his phone, and yes, he's sitting down on it. And Glinda thinks, oh no, I'm not taking that, and is attacking the reigning champion of this first round, Bambino Ludovate. And I hope I say that name properly, because if I don't, then I'm sorry, but I haven't been told how to say your name. And that is just how it is. And Glinda asks if Bambino has Blink, because Blink is very useful in situations where you want to jump somewhere, but he hasn't used it, and indeed I saw him jump. And sometimes when you go into the jumps, then you do very well, but sometimes it just seems like it doesn't work at all. And that reminds or Bambino reminds people that no Blink allowed. And well, I hope that I can do that, not Blink, but I am not sure. I think I will have to blink my eyes, because I'm only human and humans blink their eyes. Or is that not what people mean? Anyway, we've done with the first round, so let's go to some music. Thank you. it's time for round two. Yes, that's right, round two. Which will be between Ethanil and the winner of the last round, which was of course Bambino Ludovate. Or Ludovate. Or whatever. And yes, I know I say that a lot and it's probably not that funny. But anyway, Ned says, go on your trunk. And he fortunately doesn't have to explain the rules again, because he already explained them. And if you need a reminder of the rules, that's no problem. Simply go to the forums and find the Release 16 Obstacle Tournament. One versus one double elimination, which you can find in the Release 16 event forum, in the pre-release player events forum, in the Shroud of the Avatar pre-alpha testing, on the Shroud of the Avatar website. Ned says, on the trunk, and are you ready? And Bambino says, yes, I'm ready. But of course he probably still was ready from all the excitement from the previous round, which he won. And Ethanil says that I need to follow speech lessons. Well, if you give me speech lessons, maybe I can follow them. And Ethanil says, hey, I'm standing on the trunk. And well, he isn't saying that, are you blind? Because, well, that wouldn't be very nice either. But of course, it's a bit hard to see because people are far away, because they really use a lot of space for the maze and for everything that's going to happen. And Ned has seen that people are indeed on their trunks, and he is counting down, and he is going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, run, and people are supposed to go and run through the maze. And Ethanil is off, and I don't see anywhere Bambino. Ah, and of course it's very interesting to see what's going to happen. And now I see Ethanil moving too, but Ethanil seems to be lagging a little bit. But of course that may be smart too, because if your opponent takes the wrong route through the maze, then you might be able to see that and instead take the right route, which may also be the left route. You never know with mazes, because they are always complicated. And that's one of the differences between mazes and labyrinths. I think that the maze has multiple entrances and exits, or multiple ways, and a labyrinth has only one. But of course it may be the other way around. I can't really know right now. And in the meantime, they haven't really been attacking or anything, but just running through the maze, and they almost seem to have been made their way out. And yes, Bambino has made it out first, and quickly followed by Ethanil, and the throne is still in the same place, so they both know where it is and they're running towards it. And instead of jumping on the covers, they try to be smart and jump up to the covers near the throne, but instead Bambino still knows where it is because he won the previous round, but he seems to have some trouble going up. And in the meantime, he gets blown down with gusts or falls down, and by Ethanil, who also tries to jump up, and they seem to be fighting, but they both seem to be on different sides of the cupboards, so they hardly can see each other. And now they run towards each other and try to blow each other down, which is of course with gust. And in the meanwhile, Ethanil is trying to kill, but from violence, killing Bambino. And since I don't see him anymore, maybe he succeeded. And oh dear. It almost looks like Bambino has eaten the grass. And oh no, they are still alive. Or not, it's always so difficult with Gus to see, because they blow around so much and they are allowed to use a little bit of combat, but they really can't pull out the big spells. And in the meantime, There's still 3 minutes till sudden death, which means that if it happens, there won't be any more fighting going on. And they still are trying to blow each other down instead of going to the throne. And in the meantime, while Ethanil was down, Bambino again runs to the cupboards and tries to get up there to go to the throne. And Ethanil says, no you won't, and blows him down again with Gust, because Gust is a very useful spell to get your opponent blown down from high areas. And of course, they still haven't made it up there, so I hope they will make it before the sudden death, which is less than 2 minutes. And the commentary is great here from the audience. They are all cheering for everybody, and they all seem to have their favorites. And they just keep gusting and gusting, and Bambino seems to make his way up the cupboards and then get blown down, and Ethanil just stays away from the cupboards and keeps blowing down Bambino. And there's only 1 minute left, so it seems like it will almost be a sudden death, because there's not a lot of time left, and if you just keep blowing your opponent down, then you won't be on his throne. And I don't actually know what will happen in that case with sudden death, because after sudden death you are not allowed to attack anymore. And there's only 30 seconds left, and Ethanil is trying so hard to climb the boxes, and Bambino is started to do that as well, but Ethanil pulls off a last gust job and gets blown out of the entire maze area and the entire arena area, and it has to go back and travel through the maze again. And there's only 15 seconds left, and you would think that Bambino was smart enough to try to climb the boxes, but no, he isn't. And there's only 5 seconds and he fell down again, and I think that this is sudden death. And now we have to wait for Nat to say who is the winner or who is the loser, or if it will be a tie, which sometimes can be very nice ties. Anyway, what happens now, Nat? Because I do not know, and I only know that sudden death just happens, which means that neither made it through the throne, even though it's right there. How could you miss it? It's not so difficult. And Ned says Bambino made it closer, so Bambino wins again, and Bambino is declared the winner again, which means that with sudden elimination he didn't lose twice, so he isn't out, and neither is Ethanil, who also only lost once. And instead we will sometime have a loser bracket with the loser of the previous round, which was Glinda the Good Witch, and the loser of the current match probably Ethanil, if I got my rounds right. And if I don't, it will be the loser of the following match, which, since Jacob made it, is Jacob Canaan versus Sol. So they should probably make their way to the boxes. And meanwhile, in the arena, Ethanil is still standing around, wondering what's going on. And sulking, I guess. Maybe he's upset that he didn't get to eat the grass. And don't worry, you can always pull some grass out later and eat it if you want. And meanwhile, Bambino is still trying to get to the boxes. And trying to get to the throne, even though he doesn't have to anymore, because he's already the winner of this round, which was the second round for but of course the second round isn't entirely complete, because we still have another part of the second round, which is Jacob Canaan versus Sol, which have to make their way to the trunk at the other side of the maze. And that's always very good to keep things going. And I need something to drink. it seems that we're ready for the second round between Jacob Kanaan and Sol. And it seems that Ned is counting down. And he says, get ready. And, well, there was a false start. Well, it seems that some people are too enthusiastic, but that's completely okay, because Ned says, well, let's just try this again, and he counts down, and he goes 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, which is counting down, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that would be counting up, and not what we're doing. And they started to run, like Ned says, because Ned says run, and they're running through the maze, and by now they people have been paying attention and learning the route, so it looks like they are making their way through the mazes a bit quicker than in the previous contestants. And Jacob Kanaan seems to be going very fast through the maze, while Sol seems to be lagging behind, which is pretty odd because Sol probably helped build the maze. But of course that doesn't always mean that you remember the maze. And anyway, in the meantime, Jacob Kanaan has made it out of the maze and has found its way up to the boxes and already is running towards the throne, which is still in the same location. And he seems to get hurt a little. And in the meantime, people are trying to gust and people... And they... Sol seems to not use gust so much, but instead using fire. Which is always nice, because fire is something you can see at the dark. And of course it's daytime, so even now you can see the fireballs coming. And it will be very interesting to see if we will be able to use shields to deflect those fireballs, because that seems something very useful, especially with shields made from iron. And in the meantime, Jacob seems to be going onto the boxes and he seems to be getting attacked with fire a lot, and Sol attacks from below and finally seems to be able to blow Jacob down from the things. And in the meantime, while Jacob is on the floor, it seems that Sol is going to try to go to the boxes, and he didn't quite make it, and now they went to attack each other, and they went to each other, and they seem to get away from the boxes, and then they get closer again, and it seems that what they are trying to do is to attack each other, and as soon as somebody is down a little is to try to get up these boxes, because the goal is to get to the throne. And of course you only have 5 minutes in total, because otherwise it's sudden death, and then the person who is closest will win. And it seems that they are not so very interested in the throne, and instead are just playing with fire, which is never a good idea, because fire is dangerous, people. And don't go and burn your house down, because that's not a good idea, either in game or out of the game. So don't play with fire, or play with fire, but do it responsibly, although I have no idea how to do that. And anyway, in the meantime, I've lost sight of Jacob, but Sol seems to have blown him down or found a way to get onto the boxes. And it's all. And I see that Sol is just sitting there and is now trying to go and just stand there instead of making their way to the throne. I think that in the rules sometime again, because, well, they really don't seem to go for the boxes, and they seem much more interested in fighting fire with fire. And, well, that's always a good thing. And in the meantime, Sol seems to desperately try to get to the throne, so they finally got the idea. But instead, no, they got blown down and fall down, because it's not an easy course. And in the meantime, it seems that Jacob has fallen out and had to do the maze again, and they found each other again and are attacking each other. And there's only 15 seconds left, 5 seconds left. And I don't think they're going to make it, and it's going to be sudden death for sure, because they are nowhere near the boxes. And now it is who won going to win. And Ned says, oh, it's sudden, Ned, stop fighting. And the crowd goes wild. And in the meantime, they are trying to pull out the big guns because they are supposed to stop fighting, but they don't. And that's not very orderly, guys. Please cut it out. Because if you don't stop fighting, you risk getting disqualified. And that's not a good thing. Because wow, and everybody is saying stop fighting, no fighting, because suddenly that means no more spells. And only healing spells, of course, are allowed, and not attack spells. At least I thought they were allowed. Anyway, that is deciding on the winner, because I haven't seen that announced yet. And we will find out who the winner is soon of this round. And it took a while, but finally we seem to have got a resolution, because Ned decided that even though both weren't really kind to each other at the end there, because they both broke the rules, that Jacob broke the rules first, and even though he made a mistake, he lost that round. But of course that doesn't mean a lot, because you have to lose twice, so everything can still happen. And let's see, what happened was that he thought that you were allowed to attack people after sudden death, and while the rule was that nobody is allowed to use any skills after sudden death, which happens after 5 minutes. And anyway, Jacob seems to not understand what sudden death means, and sudden death means usually that there's a quick conclusion to the end of the game, and that means that the game is stopped and that one person is declared the winner, or a tie has been declared. And that doesn't mean that somebody is dying or that somebody has to die, but instead that the round or the game is dead and will be stopped and buried. Anyway, it means that we will have a... I don't know whether that means that we now have competitors for a third round, and also have competitors for the loser bracket, which is very good. And we will now go to this loser bracket, which is the loser of this round, which was Jacob Kanaan, and who was mistaken in the rules, which can happen, of course, because I mean there's so many rules sometimes. And of course against the loser from the first round, which was Glinda the Good Witch, and they are asked to go to their trunks, and I really should say because that's not very nice for you. The trunks are at the end of the maze, which I can see very far because it's still daytime, fortunately. And Ned is asking if people are ready. And Glinda says that indeed she is ready, and Jacob also is ready. So that means that we're about ready to start with the first round in the losers bracket. And of course, if you win all the loser brackets, then you still can win in the final. So even if you lose once, that doesn't mean that you lose all the entire tournament. And Ned has started counting down again, and they're off. They're running through the maze like little hamsters, which is always very cute to see. And they really did a good job, because there's a lot of walls here, and it makes me wonder how much time it took for them to put it together, because it doesn't look that something you would easily build. But of course it's 4B and they have the experience, so they probably just did it in a couple of hours, while others would take a few days. But of course, what would I know? I'm just a simple bartender and a DJ on Avatar's Radio. And of course, they almost made it through the maze, but they don't seem to be very fast, Glinda and Jacob. Maybe they stopped for lunch or something on the way, you never know. Because, well, it's a long way and you might get hungry, and they also play fighting each other a little, because you don't really do a lot of damage with all the spells that they are doing, because they seem to be firing arrows at each other, and specifically with fire. And they're both running to the throne and to the boxes, and they both run on different sides of the boxes, and it seems that they really are going very well. And oh dear, Jacob almost made it to the top, but got blown down by a gust from Glinda, and Glinda also got some attack going on, and in the meantime still got not so lucky in trying to get up there, and they are now attacking each other. And Jacob seems to be trying, but he seems to be getting blown away. And in the meantime, the situation is almost reversed, because now Glinda made it above, and in the meantime Jacob is on the bottom. And oh no, it's still not there. They both got down again. And oh no, Glinda got blown out of the maze, and that isn't good if you get blown out, because if you get blown out you are not allowed to go over the wall, so you have to do the entire maze again. And in the meantime, Bambino took advantage of Glinda not being there and trying to maneuver all the cupboards that are here, because that's not an easy thing. And because you can of course go from the sides, but you can also jump over all the cupboards which are put out over the entire lot, and it seems very difficult for both of them. Maybe they need to get a jumping diploma, which I don't know if they have in the Novium Academy. It would be something very useful to organize, maybe a jumping course, or am I giving ideas? And in the meantime, Jacob seems to have been made it. Well, Glinda is still maneuvering the maze, which also seems to require a diploma, I think, because it's a really difficult maze, and maybe you need to be a professor in mazeology. And I don't know what mazeology is, but maybe somebody can tell me, because I just invented it. And in the meantime, Jacob could go and sit on his phone, but he has chosen not to do so. Or has he already been there? Yeah, I think that he has already been there and is already celebrating, and I have not been paying attention. And it seems that Jacob is the winner of this round. And yes, congratulations to Jacob. Even though he lost the last round, he win this one, and it's double elimination, which means that unfortunately Glinda has lost. But even though she has lost this event, she's still a winner to me, because she has the courage to compete in it, and it isn't easy. Try maneuvering a maze while you're being on the fire and there is no water in sight. That isn't easy. And let's see what round we have coming up, which I don't know, so let's play some music. Seems that we're ready for another round. Yay! The crowd goes wild. Or were they already wild? Here, which would be very useful in the case of wild animals. And this round we will... I don't even know who the competitors are this round, because I haven't been paying attention, and that is because I should be reading the chat box. Like I said, don't pay attention above people's heads, because you will be late. And this round is Ethanil versus Jacob Kanaan, which is the second loser round. Of course, they are not really losers. But let us counting down, get ready, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And they are fighting each other in the maze. Ethereal and Kanaan both do damage to each other, and they are going and going and going, and the crowd goes wild and they are cheering go go go, and they seem to have gone so very fast that I have not paid attention where they are going, and in the meantime they already made it because Jacob already found it. And he, wow, I didn't even see him go up there. So it seems that Ethaniel just wasn't very fast, or he gave up. And I don't know exactly what happened, but I see Jacob in his phone, so something was really very good. And well, let's see what that says about this, because well, I have no idea who actually won. We'll be right back. it seems that we do have some kind of decision, I think, because apparently Ned was thinking about letting him have it, but of course it's not entirely in the spirit of the game, because the rules were broken, because apparently an exploit was used. There is a bug in the game that allows some people to go straight up, and I think that is maybe how people get up the moon tower, because sometimes I go there to do my job and then I see people that dancing and having a good time, which is of course great, but I always wonder how they get there. And anyway, Ned is saying that they don't have to redo it, and he's saying, "Oh, don't go up there again using a cheat or a bug, because not everybody can do it, so you can't really teach everybody because you can't really use it." And Ned is saying, "You really should go again." So it will be again a replay of Ethanol versus Jacob if they both agree to it. And of course, if one of them won't do it, then that means they will automatically lose. At least that's what I'm thinking. Because, well, if you don't want to play, then you can't play. And if you don't want to play fair, then why play at all? Because, of course, there are times when you do have to break the rules, which can be orderly, but you always should do it in situations where it's required and not where it's not needed, like in a simple competition which is just meant for fun.
To the D to in the A to the double R long. Just when you thought British's troubles are gone, stars coming back at you with a vengeance. Gonna send kids trembling to their bedrooms, here to end this. So he's playing off the thin mint.
Okay, it seems that I really had to break in with that spacebar song, Reign of Britannia, which of course is Black Star, Dark Black Star, who's Black Star, I don't know, Dark Star, that's what I was going to say, Dark Star, also known as Star Long, that's his song, and well, I have to break into it, which is chaotic and which they will really like. And I don't like it because it's order, but they decided to do a rematch and this time they hopefully will play fair. And Ned is going down, Ned is counting down because he is that good, he has made sure that everybody is ready. And they run and it's in the meantime it has become dark, which means that people are difficult to see, and so it really changes things a little bit because you may not be able to see your opponent this easy from the rules, if I remember correctly, because I'm not so smart. And in the meantime Ethanil seems to be going very well because he's already through the maze, and in the meantime also Jacob already seems to be almost out of the maze, but Ethanil seems to have quite a bit of advantage. But of course, just have being in front doesn't mean that you win, because there's still the obstacle course. And even though he was in front, he just got blown down from the boxes by Jacob through gust spells. And they are both gusting each other pretty close to the cupboards. And that means that when you get gusted, of course you can't really go jumping very well because it's so far away. And they're trying to hide from each other. And Ethanil got blown away from the boxes, but somehow he still keeps landing and is able to jump to the next box and gets gusted again, but somehow manages to hold down. And in the meantime, he's blown down again. And of course, Ethanil being on the first layer of boxes, and in the meantime, Jacob being below.
Can we have fun with this bitch?
And in the meantime, I hope that we will be. I lost him. And there's Ethanil again and Jacob. They are still fighting each other. And again, Ethanil made it to the second layer of boxes and is trying to jump to the next row of boxes. But Jacob is trying to gust him down and seems to have succeeded again, which of course is. Very good. And in the meantime, they are trying to attack each other a little bit, but not that much because they mostly try to blow each other down. And Ethanil is running away from the gust and still on the boxes somehow, but only on the first pair, and that means that there's still a very big way to go. And in the meantime, maybe Jacob can make it up there as well, because you never know, the troll is all the way on the other side, and they are trying to run and gust, but Ethanil falls down again, and Jacob keeps gusting, and Ethanil keeps gusting back, but they still don't get too close to the throne, which is of course the goal. And there's only 2 minutes left until sudden death, so that means that it's not that far anymore and not that thing. And because in the meantime Ethanil makes it to the second and the third box, but then gets blown down again, so it really isn't that easy, especially with the gust spell, and it's still a lot of fun. And now they get a new tactic, they both try to get to the last row of boxes and jump up there, but it isn't that easy always. And now Ethanil runs back to the first row, and Jacob also runs back to the first row and tries to gust again. And now Ethanil tries to gust first and seems to succeed, and now still, even though he is down, Jacob still manages to either strike back, or maybe Ethanil fell down, didn't see that. But in the meantime Ethanil seems to go very well. But of course they are still not that close, and it's mostly just because you can't really see each other. Because, and they all get blown down, but they get blown down further away. And they're still gusting each other and trying to get up there, and they have to hurry because they only have 30 seconds left of the 5 minutes that they have. And now there's only 15 seconds left. And I think they won't make it, but who knows, maybe they will try a last desperate attempt. And there's only 5 seconds left, and oh no, sudden death. Which means that now Ned is going to have to decide again who won.
Thank you.
that were a bit few quiet songs, but it seems that we do have a winner, because apparently Nath has decided that Ethanol is the winner of this round, because, well, I don't know what he decided, or, well, I don't know why he decided, I should say, because I saw him decide, but I'm not Nath, so I can't say what he decided. Well, I can say what, I'm confusing myself now, but anyway, Ethanol was the winner of that losers round, and are you a winner if you're still a loser? I have no idea. Anyway, Ethanol still got a chance for the semi-final because he only lost once, and Jacob now has lost twice, so that means that both Glinda and Jacob are out of the game, because it's double elimination, which means if you lose twice, you're out of here, or at least you're out of the competition. Anyway, we now have interesting things going on, because we have the semi-final going on, and that means that it will be the winner of round 2 by Milan Dodefeting and Sol, which are now already running through the maze, because Nath has already done the countdown, and he they're running and running and running like little hamsters, and I say hamsters, but maybe this release I should say rabbits, because this is more like a rabbit release, because of it being with almost Easter when this is done. Anyway, they run through the maze and run and run, but it seems that Bambino made it out first and is already on the boxes, and instead of using the first one, he's using the last one, and he's running back and forth, and Sol now also made it out of the maze, and instead of attacking has decided to try and get also on the boxes and find their way to the throne first, and they are running, and oh no, it seems that Bambino has made somehow fell out of the field and now has to do the maze again, but they seem to really get to know the maze now very well, and in the meantime Sol is trying to get on the boxes while Bambino is again running through the maze, and Sol seems to have made it up to the first round and is trying to get the courage to go to the next boxes, because they're quite far away and it isn't an easy job to jump if you have never done it, and I'm not sure that I could do it, and maybe I should give it a try sometime. And anyway, Sol is indeed jumped onto the second row and now tried to jump to the third row but missed, so they have to run all the way back, or they can try to get on top of the next boxes, and in the meantime Bambino is trying to get through the maze and almost has made it through the maze again, and now can also start to conquer the boxes, which seems to be where most people get to everybody. Ooh, and now they seem to be attacking each other, because they found each other again, and that is very nice, and they are using fire and gust, and it seems that Bambino was blown down and Sol is trying to get on the boxes, but Bambino is trying to gust her down again and not doing a very good job, because he keeps stumbling and falling down, and that may also be because of Sol also trying to send flames his way and gusting, and oh dear, they really seem to be going at it for each other, and oh, now also Sol falls down from the boxes, which is a big thing, because if you fall down then you have to walk all the way back, and that's quite a big way, and that's why It's so hard to reach the throne even if it is pretty close by, because I can see it right there. Why don't you go up there? No, it's that they choose to attack each other because they really seem to not like each other for winning. Because they are both winners, I guess. Anyway, they are in the semi-final, so they must have been doing something right so far. But now I'm not much seeing it because I just see them being distracted with each other and trying to attack each other. And now Bambino is trying to get on the boxes while Sol is being stumbling and falling down. And oh, now Bambino also falls from the boxes. So they are both on the ground level. And in the meantime, the time has been so long that there's only 1 minute left till sudden death. Which he says as SD, which is something entirely different. But I read it as sudden death because to me, since we're in the competition, that's what it means. And they are still attacking each other and trying to blow each other down. And at the meantime, when somebody is blown down, trying to get on top of the boxes. And it seems that now, even though Sol is doing her best, it seems that Bambino is getting higher, but not quite to the throne. And now Bambino is trying to run away from Sol, and because somebody can't see you, then they can't curse you. And they're still trying to fire each other, and now they have to fight each other again. And Bambino almost got it, but he missed, and he went to the other side of the... Well, that's odd. He went all the way to the other side of the square that holds this lot where the tournament is. And that wasn't very smart because his phone is in the middle and not at the end. And now they have to find their way all the way up there to the boxes. And now it seems that 5 minutes have passed because Ned says sudden death. And oh, that means that it's ended, and that means that they really should stop attacking each other, because when sudden death has done, it means that you can't use any skills anymore. And Ned says Bambino wins, because, and the people are thinking that Sol probably missed the chat because it has been sudden death. And that's not that strange, because when you're fighting and trying to get up there, you're really trying to do a good job. But it seems that because of the sudden death, Bambino wins this round. Thank you. it seems that there has been a sudden attack of chaos, because in a complete and unprecedented move, it has been a different ruling, because even though Bambino could have won, he said, well, no, Sol missed the chat, so let's do this again. And so Matt has decided, okay, let's do this again. So we have a repeat of the semifinals of Bambino versus Sol. And they are both on their trunks, and Matt says, get ready, and he's counting down, and he's going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, which is counting down, which I just said, and he says run, and so they run like the rabbits through the maze, which is what is very good. And I can see Sol going crazy, and it seems that Sol is there, but I don't know what happened to Bambino, because I don't see him anywhere, but I see the effects of spells, and now Bambino is getting closer to the maze, because Bambino seems to have memorized the maze better, so he's already out and is making his way to the boxes, while Sol is still going through the maze and having a good job, having a difficult job of it. And Bambino has made it on the first row of boxes and is already trying, and Sol is trying from the maze to try to attack, and in the meantime Sol made it out of the maze and trying to blow down Bambino, who is desperately trying to jump for the throne and missed, and is now on the grass, but not quite out, because it's not time to eat the grass just yet, which is what Amber should say. But she's not here, so she can't say that, and I have to do it, even though there is no grass eating, and that's what's happening. But now they both made their way up again, and they seem to at least standing up, and Bambino has made his way up to the first row of boxes again, because he seems to be very smart at this, and Sol just seems to be waiting for him, and now they're just trying to gush each other down, while Sol is trying to fight fire with fire and fire arrows or fireballs at him, and still try, they get closer to each other, and now Sol is trying to get up there, and Bambino's trying to not let her win, and instead is trying to blow him down, and in the meantime Sol is just trying to get still stay in the middle, while Bambino is trying to gust her down from where she is, which is in the middle of the field and near the boxes with the throne. But they get blown down again, and so they will beat each other up a little bit again and try to roast each other, which is not very good, because it is very warm and that we don't really need a roasted human, because, well, it's, we are not quite delicious. And anyway, they are fighting very far from me, so I can't easily see it, but I see Sol trying to fight and somehow blowing Bambino out of the maze again, out of the field, which means that Bambino has to fight the maze again, while Sol is trying to climb boxes and trying to get up there and waiting for Bambino almost. And the crowd is going wild and saying that lucky for Bambino that Sol isn't a good jumper, because she does seem to have some trouble, and so Bambino may still win even though he has to travel the entire maze, which is really quite a big one with all the extra openings, because but he seems to almost have made it, while Sol is trying to navigate the first box and doing a pretty good job of it, and now has to make the very large jump to the second box, and oh, she misses, which is not such a big surprise, because it really is an incredible jump to make, and not that easy at all. And in the meantime, Bambino has almost made it out of the maze again, which means that he will probably come and attack again, and yes, Sol, who is still on the first boxes, gets attacked and gets blown off of even off the first row of boxes. And Bambino uses that to travel through the entire row and try to get up again to the second row, but he gets gusted, and that means that he won't be able to defend himself much while Sol is trying to fire arrows or fireballs at him, and of course trying to get up there. And in the meantime, it means that I've been talking so long that I've already been talking for 5 minutes, because it seems that the time is up and Ned says sudden death, and that means that after sudden death you're not allowed to use your skills anymore. And so now we will go find out who has won this round, which is the semi-final between Bambino Ludafate and Sol. Seems that indeed we do have a winner, because it seems that Bambino was closer to the goal, so Bambino won that round yet again, and I lost count how many times he won. And that means that the next round will be between Ethanil and Sol, because it will be the losers round of the semi-finals, and that means that whoever wins this still has a chance to win the finals, which is currently only Bambino. And of course that means that it is also possible that if chaos strikes, that there will be no final, and that would be odd. So we will have Sol versus Ethanil first in the semi-final, and Ned is saying, are you ready? And Ethanil is saying yes. And Sol is asking if is not saying that they are ready, but Ethanil is ready, and now Sol is ready too, which means that we can get ready to begin. And that means that Ned can go and count down and go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, as he has been doing very well. So the net is apparently counting and going well, and now we can run, and they're going off like rabbits, and they are trying to run through the maze as fast as they can, but they still won't be able to do this very much, because they keep already attacking each other, which means that they can get interrupted. And Ethanil seems to take some damage from Sol, because which means that Ethanil will be in front, because if you go and attack, then you have to stand still, and that means that you can't really fight very easily, because it's very difficult to fight and run. And it seems indeed that Ethanil has made it almost out of the maze already, and in the meantime Sol is still trying and also get it out of the maze. And it seems that Ethanil is trying to find the best way up the boxes, and already up the first box, and it seems to take some damage from Sol, but not really a lot. And Ethanil is just waiting for Sol to move either away or to do something, and he is jumping onto the second row of boxes and making it to the other side of the arena. And in the meantime Sol is traveling up to the box on the other side, and also trying to get to the other boxes. and almost gets gusted down, and oh no, Sol falls down because she misses the jump, and it means that Ethmil is made it up to the top of the boxes and trying to go down, and oh, he gets blown down also, which will have hurt a lot because he got blown down from the top floor instead of the bottom floor. And of course now they start to fight each other again, and Sol is trying very hard with fire to keep Ethanil away from the boxes because Sol wants to be closer and Sol wants to win. And of course Ethanil wins too because Ethanil says no you. And in the meantime there's only 3 minutes left in this fight. And there seems to be a little commotion going on and the crowd is going wild and they're still fighting. And in the meantime Sol makes it up until the first box and blows Ethanil down. And Sol is trying to get to the boxes, and that's not so very easy because the boxes are very far and there are so many of them. And of course Sol gets blown out of the arena, which means that she has to do the arena again, and that gives Ethanil time to jump again up onto the boxes, which he can do very well and very fast. And he has made it to the top floor again where the throne is, but that doesn't mean that you win because there's still quite a few jumps, and he almost has made it, and yes, he seems to have reached the throne and he sits down, so Ethanil is the winner of this round, of this semi-final between Sol and Ethanil. And that means that since Ethanil is the winner, that the finals will go between Bambino Ludovati and Ethanil. It seems that we have a great final because it will be between Bambino Ludovati and Ethanil, and that explains that if they, let me see what was it because it's a bit far away, Ned says if Bambino wins, he will claim first place because he hasn't lost yet. And if Bambino loses, then there will be another fight because you have to lose twice in order to get thrown out of the tournament. Like, some people were. And Ned asks if people are ready, and I think we are not entirely ready yet, but we are now ready and we are off. Ned is counting down because we are all both ready, and Ned is going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and run, and people are paying attention because they are running like crazy through the maze, and Ethanol seems to be doing very well because he seems to be doing great even though he's chased by gusts. And in the meantime, we are looking for Bambino, who is also close to Ethanil and also gusting and trying to blow people out of the maze, but that isn't working because Ethanil is just too fast, and they are now both out of the maze and still looking forward to a big fight. And instead of going onto the cupboards again, they are fighting. Okay, that's fine. Just go and fight each other. And they are both gusting each other and not really throwing much fire, even though they have their fiery sticks. And they are fighting and fighting, and they are just blowing each other down, which means that they can't go to the cupboards and try to go to the throne, which is this time even more difficult because you have to make quite a few jumps to make it there. And it seems that Bambino is closer to the boxes, but Ethanil is trying to defend and also get on the boxes. But he's not having very much luck, and now he passes, but Bambino recovers himself, and they seem to want to blow each other out of the arena. And it's almost as if it's succeeding, because it was not a success, and they're both still in the arena and still trying to either blow each other down and prevent each other from winning. And of course, that means that it will be quite interesting to see what happens. And now Bambino seems to want to go and make it, because of course there's still the 5-minute timer, so you can't just wait a little bit, but he gets blown down. But fortunately for him, the entrance to everything is quite early and quite close. And in the meantime, Ethanil also misses a jump, so he also falls down. And not only that, but he seems to have fallen down, and oh, this is so exciting. And yes, Ethanil has made it out of the maze, so now Bambino can try to get up there, and he is doing so while Ethanil is running through the maze and trying to get back to Bambino to prevent him from running through the maze. But Bambino is on the second layer of boxes and now trying to get onto the third, and he has made it on top while Ethanil is still below. But of course it doesn't mean that he wins, because Bambino is very fast but misses a jump, and so gets very much under gets very much back to the start and has to run two layers of boxes again, while Ethanil is still running through the maze. And even though you would say that anybody that they already win, the jumps aren't easy, so you can still lose. And it turns out that there is not much time left, there's only 1 minute of time left, so you really have to hurry up now. And Ethanil is trying to blow Bambino down with gusts, and he seems to have succeeded. So now Ethanil, even though he is in the maze, has gusted all the way over there to the boxes and blown Bambino down a little bit, which means that he can try to get through the maze and get on the boxes himself. And there's not much time left because there's only 5 seconds left. And oh dear, the net is calling sudden death, and that means that we can't use our skills anymore. And that likely means, I think, that Bambino is probably the winner because he's much closer and Ethanel is still stuck in the maze. But we will see if I'm right after this. Yes, it seems that I was right. Yay, the crowd goes wild. Yay, but they don't go wild for me because that would be weird. No, instead they go wild for the winner, Bambino Ludifatti, of this 4B Arts Release 16 Obstacle Tournament, or the New Britannia Builders of Bemusing Bewilderments, I should say, really, because that's their real name, and it's not 4B even though they pretend it is. Yes, that's quite weird and I don't understand it either, but that's the way it is. And of course, I don't know the exact standings because, well, I'm not a math person because I don't know exactly how it works, but maybe Ned will be kind enough to post it in the chat. And I do know that Bambino Ludifatti wins the tournament, and well, probably Ethanil second, and well, we will have to find out who's third and who's fourth. But this was a great tournament, and of course 4B will be having more tournaments into the future, and hopefully also tournaments like this, because they are great fun, especially with the mazes and the challenge tournaments and just the obstacle courses. It's really a great tournament to see and watch and see everybody run like a rabbit and go through all this event, and it's really a great competition that they built here for 4B. And let's see what they have more coming on, because 4B doesn't just have the obstacle tournament. Today they also have the Easter Maze event, which will be at 11 Central, and that will be with Ria, I think, so we will see what happens there. But for so far, this is the Release 16 4B Obstacle Tournament. Won by Bambino Ludifatti. Thank you. we are back, because even though the winner has been declared, one, some of the prizes are of course fighting net. Who is responsible for the event? And we will have the exhibition matches now going on, and the first one will be between net and the winner Bambino. So Bambino is thinking, oh god, I'm not going to win this, so I want to fight against somebody else, so I need help, oh please help also. And they are saying, no, it's one versus one, you have to do it alone. And of course they are going to, and instead of Net counting down for himself, which would be weird, we now have Lon, who is also up for me, I think, and also going to help with the countdown. And yes, Lon is also up for me, and Lon is counting down, and he is doing just a good job as Net is doing, and he's going 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And they are going and going, and they are running like rabbits through the maze, and of course Net knows the maze very well, so he's in front. But that doesn't mean that Bambino is doing so bad, because Bambino is running right behind him and trying to stop Net, and Net is, in the meantime, Net is, has stopped in the middle, and oh no. That means that even though Net stopped and maybe got blown down, it means that Bambino is running in front of him. And so that means that Bambino will likely make it out of the maze first if Net doesn't stop him, because they're both in the maze still, and they seem to be taking a very long time. And of course they are trying to gust each other down, and that takes a long time, because if you get gusted down, then you also have to wait a little bit before you can get up again. And it seems that indeed Bambino has taken advantage of all the gusting and has made it out first, but he runs back for some reason, and that means that Net in the meantime also passes him by and makes his way up the boxes. And that's the, and Bambino thinks, oh god, I'm not going to let that happen, and he's using gust, and Net is shooting arrows, but it's not using fire, which is something that I haven't seen before, but seems to be using some kind of electricity, which is of course also scary. And that means that he seems to be fighting, and Net seems to miss. And Bambino shoots a gust spell, but Net misses it, and they seem to be fighting each other, and Net seems to also be able to gust each other. And Net uses the gust to take advantage to blow Bambino out of the way and make it up the first row of boxes, but he gets fallen down again. And in the meantime, Lon says that it's 3 minutes to sudden death, which means that they are going pretty fast, but since they are still attacking each other, that means also that they won't be going close to the phone. And that means that if they are trying to fight, and now Bambino is trying to blow Net out of the arena with using gas, but they seem to miss, and so Net is trying to shoot back with his electricity, I think it is, on Bambino, and it seems to be doing a slightly damage, but not that much, because he just keeps on going. And now he gets blown down because Net threw in a sudden gust, and in the meantime it's only 2 minutes to sudden death, so they really have to start hurrying up, because it isn't easy. And in the meantime, Bambino seems to have made it up the first row of boxes and gets blown down, and Net makes it up to the first row and gets also got blown down, so they don't really go anywhere. And now they seem to make it up to the first row of boxes, but Bambino gets blown down and he falls into the good side of the arena this time, which means that he doesn't have to do the maze all over again. But Net seems to run away, which is very odd, because I haven't seen it before, but that is something that sometimes happens, I guess, if people run away. And because he ran away, he has to do the maze again. And Bambino makes his way up the boxes. And he makes it on the far side, so Matt can't shoot him with his electric arrows. And he seems to almost get blown down, but he seems to quickly hide and so seems to make it all the way up to the top. And Ned is desperately trying to go through the maze and fight at the same time. And in the meantime, Bambino seems to fight and almost on the last jump he misses. And that means that he almost could touch the throne, but he still missed. And in the meantime, Ned is almost through the maze. And now Bambino has to go all the way through the arena again from one side to the other on the top layer, and that can't be very easy. And Ned seems to be giving up or just stacking and still firing, but Bambino is just standing there because and taking it because he seems to be trying to get the courage to jump some more boxes. And he seems to misjump and fall down. Well, Ned is now also out of the maze, and that's too late because sudden death has happened. And Bambino was closer, so I think that Bambino probably won this one as well. So, well, we will have to figure that out at least. And anyway, that was certainly not the winner. That we run out of time for the other exhibition matches, so I won't be broadcasting those right now because they are not happening, and that means that I can't broadcast them and something or another. Anyway, I had a lot of fun, and since we it seems that the winners are also known, because the first prize went to Bambino, who didn't just beat everybody else but who also beat Ned in the first exhibition match, and the second place went to Ethanil, and the third place went to Sol, which is very interesting because I thought that they were PvPers, and they are not just PvPers but great jumpers as well. And for so far, the 4B R16 obstacle tournament, and let's hope we'll do it again for release 17, or maybe 18, or maybe 25, or maybe 386, who knows.